Okay, continuation of the topic, DC analysis problems. So earlier two videos I covered in solving the two or three videos covered in solving the problems purely in DC analysis. So some more problems are pending. Now I am doing that. So this is one of the problem asked in GATE. Your question is to find E. So observe carefully, here 2 volts supply, 8 volts, here 12 volts, here 4 volts. Okay, here 0 means grounded, 10 volts, then here V2, V1. So question is to find E value. Then we have to find V2, we have to find V1 also. This is 0 means it is grounded. So we can think like, we can draw like this. It's like a closed. Physically, it is appearing like a open, but electrically it is closed. 0 means grounded. So with respect to this ground, what should be the voltage here? 10. So therefore, this must be 10 volts. Now you write the loop equation. That is 10 plus 8 plus E plus 12 is equal to 0. So solve for E. 12 plus 8, 20, so you'll get minus 30. This is the answer. So simply writing KVL or mesh equation, we got the answer E. Then to find V1, what is the rule I said? Start at this point, go to ground, any shortest path. So therefore V1 is equal to, I can go any path. If I go like this, V1 equal to minus 4 minus E. So E is minus 30 now, so you'll get plus 30. Then minus 8. So simplify, you will get 18 volts. Similarly, V2, same rule. Start at V2, go to ground. This is the shortest path. So V2 equal to 2 minus 8. So it is minus 6. Plus 2 minus 8 equal to minus 6. So like that we can solve. This is a fundamental basic problem. Is another problem, find V. Find V, this is the V. So what is the rule I said? Start at positive, go to negative. Directly you'll get it. Start at positive, go to negative. You'll get the answer. So always voltage, polarity must be there, which side positive, which side negative. Started positive, go to negative, and all these values are known. Go through the known path. If you go through 2 ohms, what is the voltage here? Don't know. So directly this voltage is known. Therefore, it is minus 5 plus 4, again plus 4. So 4 plus 4, 8, 8 minus 5. So it is. as a fundamental problems, easy problems. Ask in gate 97. Find the current I. Find the current I. It is again based on the current law only. So just observe. What is the current here? 4 amps. Here 3 given. Here 3 given. Here current 4 given. That means how much should enter here? 4 leaving, 3 leaving means compulsory 7 should come here. 7 ampere current should come here. Now here 5, here 3. 5 plus 3 is 8. In this 8, 7 going this side. So what is the current remaining here? 5 plus 3, 8. 8 minus 7 means 1. Now here 7 entering. Here 1 entering. Here 4 is entering. So what is the total? 7 plus 1, 8. 8 plus 4, 12. What is the current this side? 12. But what is the question asking? I in opposite direction. So what is the I answer will be? Minus 12 amps. Minus 12. So it is based on the current law. Here we know 4, here we know 3. So this unknown we can find. Like that we have to start. Purely based on current law. There's another problem, find I. This is the current I. So once again, observe carefully. What is the given? Here current 1 given. Here also 1 given. That means this must be compulsory 2 amps. This 2 ampere is going top side. What is the written current? Compulsory 2 only. Don't waste your time. How much will flow through V1? How much is flowing through R? You can't use any current division formula. But whatever current going top line, same current should come back. It's a fundamental. So this is 2. This is 2. This is 2. This must be 4. It is asking I reverse. So what is the I now? Minus 4 amps. So this side no use. So directly I started here and got here. This is asked in IES 2014 triple E. Any element connected in is given a 4 statements. Which of the above statements is or are correct? So more than one statement can be correct. So statement 1 is only correct, or 2 and 3 correct, 2 correct, or 1 and 4 correct. So based on the source transformation concept. So any element connected in series with a ideal current source is redundant. Current source is always followed by parallel resistance. But here element in series with current source is redundant. It's a correct statement. And parallel with ideal current source is redundant. That is not redundant, that is allowed. So series with voltage source is redundant. Voltage source resistance series allowed, it is not redundant. Parallel with voltage source is redundant. That means first and fourth correct, clear. He is asking redundant, which are the correct statement. So redundant is a correct. Parallel with voltage source is a redundant, therefore correct. So therefore T 194 is correct. So this 194 is correct. So if you recollect, always we connect voltage source in series with resistor. This is allowed. And current source always parallel with resistor. This is allowed. So current resistor series not allowed. Voltage source resistor parallel not allowed. So statement one not allowed is saying, statement fourth is also not allowed is saying, so they are the correct statements. Therefore 194 is correct. Now here power supplied by a voltage source. Power supplied by voltage source. First, always observe the problem carefully. Power supplied by voltage source. So voltage is given, we need to find the current. This current we have to find. This product will give you power. But this current is not simple. Here 1 ampere given, 2 ampere given. This must be compulsory 3 amps. This is 3, this is I. This current must be 3 plus I. So in this 3 plus I, 1 ampere going this side now. What is remaining? 2 plus I. 2 plus I, 2 going this side. So what is the current here? I. So in this current distribution, how many unknowns we are coming across? Only 1. Therefore, one mesh equation needed to solve for I. Only one mesh equation needed to solve for I. How to write that mesh equation? Don't go via current source. Don't go via current source. So if I started here, minus 10 plus 2 into 3 plus I plus 2 into 2 plus I is equal to 0. So here we have to solve for I. So minus 10, then 6 plus 2i plus 4 plus 2i equal to 0. So 6 plus 4, 10, minus 10 cancel, therefore I equal to 0. When current is 0, what is power supplied by source? 10 into 0 equal to 0, na? So answer is 0. So we should know how to use current distribution concept. Write mesh equation, solve for I, then power supply. So this is something very, very important problem. First, understand the problem. A conductor of diameter D. A conductor of diameter D. Length L. Consumes a power of, how much power it consume? W, some watts, W watts. When a current I flows through it, so how much current is flowing in this conductor? I. What will be the power? What will be the power consumed if D is doubled. So this D is doubled. So pipe, wire length is becoming double, not length, diameter is becoming double. And length L is half. Length is reduced to half. Current is tripled. So what is the current they are sending? 3 times more current is sending. So current is increased by 3 times. Diameter is doubled. Length is half. Under this manipulation, what is the power? What is the power formula? I square into R. Power is I square R. But this R depends on rho L by A. This R value depends on rho L by A. So what is the current here? Current is increasing 3 times. Current is increasing 3 times. So there is another interesting, actually, this problem should not be solved like this. I will solve differently. First, what is the resistance, effect of resistance? R equal to rho L by A. So resistance material not changing, rho remains same. Now length is reduced to L by 2 na. Okay, then area. Area is pi r square. Area is pi r square. So what is the, if diameter is doubled, so this is r na. From this point to this is r, like a, you remember, like a circuit. So when diameter is doubled, R is also becoming double. So it is 2R. Square. What is this value? Rho L by 2 square is 4. 4 into 2, 8. Pi R square. This rho L by A is R1. Or I am calling this is R2. So from this, what is the conclusion? R2 is equal to R1 by 8. So resistance, how much decreased? 8 times decreased. The basic idea, there is a source, there is a resistance. This resistance R2 is reduced by 8 times. When this resistance is reduced, automatically current increase 8 times na. Current increase 8 times. Obviously, any circuit, when resistance is decreased, current will increase 8 times. In addition to this 8 times, so there is also another thing, current increased by 3 more times. 3 more times. That is increased 3 more times, so probably because of voltage is increased 3 more times. So effectively 3 and 8, 24 times current is increased. 24 times current is increased. Now therefore P is equal to I2 square R2. How many times it is increased to? 24 times. I1 square. What is R2? R1 by 8. So if you simplify, 24 into 24 by 8. I1 square into R1. What is this one now? I am calling this is P2. This is P1. So how many times power is increased? 72 times. So this D is correct. So when these parameters are changing, resistance decreased by 8 times. Because it is decreased by 8 times, current is increasing 8 times. And in addition to that, extra current also 3 times increased comparing with the initial. So effectively 24 times is increasing. That is the secret concept of this problem. If you take only current 3 times, if you take current only 3 times, 3i1 square into r1 by 8, it is becoming 9 by 8. So there is no 9 by 8 now here. So that is the secret. That's how. That is the power of IS. These are all wonderful, important, interesting questions. Mostly in first attempt we do mistake, but carefully you have to learn. This is another model. A capacitor is charged by a constant current source which is turned on for 1 second. Observe this. Capacitor is charged by a current source. Capacitor is charged with the help of current source. Now imagine there is a switch. And this is on for 1 second only. Assuming capacitor is initially uncharged. So before switch closed, no voltage in the capacitor. Determine the charge delivered to and power supplied by source if C is equal to 1 millifarad. And what is this current is 10 milliamps. So this graph is given. 10 milliampere current flowing through capacitor, how much duration? 1 second only. So what is the charge delivered to capacitor? What is the power? Charge is nothing but area under current curve. What is the area here constant? So this just multiply. It is 10 milliampere into 1 become 10 millicoulombs. That is the charge. When this much charge is transferred to capacitor, what is the voltage developed in the capacitor? V is equal to Q by C. Q is 10 millicoulombs, C is 1 milli, so 10 volts is available in capacitor. Now power supplied by source. What is the power formula? Power is nothing but voltage into current. Voltage into current. So what is the voltage? 10. How much current flowing? 10 milliampere. So 10 milliampere current at any given time 0 to 1 in 1 second, what is the current here available? 10 milliampere. 10 milliampere. And voltage is 10 volts. So voltage into current, just multiply 100 milliwatts. At any given time, 100 milliwatts. So that is the power. Power supplied by source. Current into voltage multiplied. This is another interesting. Consider a circuit comprising only resistors with a constant resistance and ideal independent DC voltage sources. So circuit contain many voltage sources, many resistors. How they are connected, not given. If all resistors are scaled down by factor 10, all source voltages are scaled up by factor 10, the power dissipated in the circuit scales up to by a factor of. So voltage is scaled up by factor 10, resistances decreased by 10. But multiple sources are there, multiple resistors are there. You can try with the single source, single resistor. The same rule is applicable even if you take multiple sources, multiple resistors. I have tried and verified it is coming same. So with V1 and R1, what is the power? V1 square by R1. With the second case, P2 is V2 square by R2. But V2 increased by 10 times na 10 V1. What is R2? Decreased by 10 times. R1 by 10. So simplify, you are getting 1000 P1. So power is increased by 1000 times. Power is increased by 1000 times. So like that we can answer. Only confusion is, but here given all resistors are scaled means it is not one resistor, many resistors. And DC voltage is sources, multiple sources, randomly connected. But here I tried with the single source, single resistor. I got my own doubt. Will it be same if we take more than one source, more than one resistor? I have taken, I got same answer. That's why I am verifying with the single source. A network consists of several resistances, one of which is designated as R, and two constant sources. The power consumed by resistor R is P1 when first source is acting alone, and P2 when the second source is acting alone. If the both of the sources are acting simultaneously, then power consumed by resistor R is. In the above case, if P1 is 18 watts and P2 is 50 watts, then maximum and minimum power dissipated in resistor R is. So given a big description, but concept is simple. So with the source one active, it is basically when one source is the alone active, power dissipated is P1. So I1 square R, resistors R. Then with the second source is active, what is P2 given? I2 square R. Now when both the sources are active, total power is not P1 plus P2. You can't use superposition theorem for power. Power is a nonlinear function. Additive property, scaling property, superposition principle, superposition theorem. We cannot use it for power. Voltage, current, we can use it, but for power, we should not use it. So what is the idea? Power convert into current. So what is I1? Root P1 by R. What is P1 given? 8. Given P1 given as 18. So 3 root 2 by R. Second case, what is I2? Root P2 by R. Simplify, you get this. What is the total current? Plus or minus I1 plus or minus I2 square into R. Why this plus or minus? With that particular source alone, which direction current flowing, we don't know. So that's why plus or minus. If both are positive or both are negative, power will be highest. One is positive, one is negative, power will be lowest. That's why it's asking maximum and minimum. Maximum is possible with the same polarity. Minimum is possible with the opposite polarity. With the same polarity, you will get 128 watts. With the opposite polarity, 8 watts. So this is a simple problem. Values given in terms of power is asking total power. Don't add individually, convert into currents, then take plus or minus square into R. Like this, we can solve. This is the bulb problem. This is very conceptually very interesting. When what is the bulb concept? Whenever We purchase a bulb in the shop. Internally, there is a filament. And here we connect 230 volts. 230 volts AC we apply. So Indian standard power supply is 230 volts. On the surface of this bulb, they write 230 volts. When you purchase a 40 watt bulb, they write 40 watts. You want to buy 60 watt bulb, they write 60 watts. So what is the purpose of writing this is, when you apply a rated voltage of 230, this bulb guarantee consume 40 watts. If it is written 60 watt, when you apply 230 volts, this bulb guarantee consume 60 watts. So that is the basic idea of the writing information on the surface of the bulb. So with this condition, we can find the bulb resistance. What is the power formula? V square by R. If it is a 40 watt bulb, 40 equal to 230 square by R, R 40. So using this, we can find a 40 watt bulb resistance. That is nothing but 230 square by 40. Like that we can do it. So what is the problem? What is the question here? Look at problem first. A 40 watt, 60 watt bulbs connected in series across 230 volts 50 H. So what is the each bulb resistance? Which bulb filament thickness is more? What is the power in each bulb, power dissipation in each bulb? Which bulb glows brighter? What is the total power dissipation in both the bulbs? What will happen if 100 watt bulb connected in series? Then last, repeat all the above questions if they are connected in parallel. So let us start with what is the each bulb resistance. So 40 watt bulb, 60 watt bulbs, two different bulbs connected in series. Before they connect, we have to find what is the bulb resistance. So using this formula, you can find what is the R 40, 230 square by 40, 1.32K. Similarly, 60 watt bulb resistance, 230 square by 60, you will get this. Which bulb resistance is more? 40 watt bulb resistance is more. And we know that R is equal to rho L by A. Any bulb tungsten material, so rho will not change, L will not change, they change only thickness of the filament, accordingly resistance will change. So which resistance is more? 1.32, so 40 watt. So second is what? Which bulb filament thickness is more? Thicker means less resistance. Thicker means resistance. So therefore, 60 watt bulb is thicker. 60 watt bulb is thicker. Thickness is more means resistance is less. R40 greater than R60. So 60 watt bulb resistance is less, and that is linked with more area. So B also we have done. Such type of bulbs are connected in series. When they are connected in series, what is the total resistance now? R40 plus R60 is 2.2K. That is the total resistance. Then how much current will flow? 230 by 2.2K. So 0.1 ampere. 0.1 ampere current flowing through both the bulbs because they are in series na. What is power in 40 watt now? 0.1 square into 40 watt bulb resistance is 1.32K, so 13.2 watts. Power in 60 watt bulb, same way, 0.1 square into 0.88 K. If you simplify, you get 9 watts. What is the total power dispatched in both the bulbs? 13.2 plus 9 is 22.2 watts. So finally, which bulb glows brighter, more power in 40 watts? Na, that is 13.2. This bulb rating is less, but power consumption is 13.2. 60 watt bulb rating is more, but power dissipated is 9 watts. Therefore, 40 watt bulb glows brighter. 40 watt bulb glows brighter. What is the next question? If 100 watt bulb is connected extra series, what happens? The total power consumption is same or increasing or decreasing? Just see the fun of it. Only 40 watt bulb is connected to this. How much power dissipate here? 40 watts. Because of the 60 watt bulb extra connected in series, total power is not 100. Total power reduced to how much? 22.2 na. So instead of 40, now power is reduced. If you connect another 100 watt bulb in series, total power will be further reduced. So it will be less than 22.2. So keep on add the bulbs, so the total power dissipation will be reducing. That is the reason the domestic connections all are connected in parallel. If all are in parallel, every device will get a rated voltage. If all are in series, applied voltage is dividing. Each will not get rated voltage, so performance will be affected. That's why all should be connected in series. What is the last question? Repeat all if they are connected in parallel. When bulbs are connected in parallel, their resistances will not change. That is already manufactured. Bulb is available, resistances are fixed, so it will not change. So bulb resistance remain same. What is power in each bulb connected in parallel na? So power in first bulb is 40 watts, second bulb is 60 watts, total power consumption is 100 watts, and obviously 60 watt bulb glows brighter than 40 watt bulb. So when they are in parallel, answers are very easy. Series confusion, that's why series part is asked. What is asked in the gate exam is which bulb glows brighter only asked. But for understanding that, I included some more questions and answering. I hope you understand this. So I think I will stop at this moment. Next class, I will solve remaining problems. With that, DC problems will be over.